This is the RepRap discount smart controller. I'm going to show you how to hook this up to the MKS Gen L board in just a moment. Let me just point out some quick things about this. On the back of the LCD, we have two connectors, and we also have a SD card slot. And then on the front, we have a little adjustable thing to move up and down, a microphone, and a reset button. And in a moment, I'll show you how to connect them. Okay, the connector for the LCD is these two connections. This is EXP1 and this is EXP2. In a moment, I'll show you the back of the LCD and what connectors are on that. As you can see, there's two connectors on the back of the Smart RepRap Discount LCD. There's EXP1 and EXP2. They're both notched, so the ribbon cables will fit in with the notches. That's the same on the MKS Gen L board for the printer. And over here we have a SD card socket. And in a moment, I'll show you how to connect the two together. Okay, to connect, all we have to do is match the notch on the ribbon cable to EXP1 and then match the notch on EXP1 on the smart LCD. Then do the same for EXP2 and then connect it to the LCD as well. And in a moment, I'll show you how to connect the serial USB and program the Marlin firmware. Okay, to connect the programming cable, you take this end of the USB serial cable and connect it to your board. Take the other end and plug it into your computer and you'll hear a beep. Now notice that the LCD has come on, so that's good. And in a moment, I'll show you how to load the firmware. Okay, we're in the Marlin folder for 1.1.8. We're going to open up the folder. We're going to go to the Marlin folder. We're going to hit M on the keyboard to get us to the marlin.ino. We're going to open that up. Okay, now we're going to go to the configuration.h tab and we're going to search on SD. So we're at LCD and SD support. So we're going to scroll down. Now, for those that don't know, you can pick the language that you'd like from above by using these two letters, or three letters, or four letters, depending upon what you're doing. In this case, we're going to stick with English. And then you also have the option of Japanese characters. And then down here, since we have an SD card on the back, we're going to uncomment this. That way we can use it. And we're not going to uncomment this at the moment. This is SD check and retry. Sometimes when you have an issue, you can uncomment this and it usually might address your issue. So moving on down here, we're going to find the speaker. So here we are, speaker and buzzer. Since we have a speaker on the front of this panel, we're going to uncomment that. And then we're going to search on RepRap discount. Now this is the RepRap discount smart controller. So we're going to uncomment this. This is the actual setting in the driver. So we're going to check to see that we have the right board. We're using the Arduino Mega 2560 because it has a similar architecture for the MKS Gen L board. So that's good. And then we don't have a port selected yet, so we're gonna check that and then go back and verify it's checked, which it is. So now we're gonna click compile and upload, which says upload here. And in a moment, it'll load the firmware. And then I'll demonstrate on the firmware that's loaded on the board what it looks like. Okay, after the load, it rebooted and showed you the screen. So to actuate it, you can press this button to select what you're looking for. You can scroll up and down. Keep in mind, if it rolls the wrong way, there's a setting in the actual driver to change it, so you can reverse it. And if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.